my beautiful crafty friends. You guys, I had a chance to make some Christmas projects and I wanted to share them with you. I find myself leaning towards more home decor and wanting to create more towards the home decor, and I'm having a lot of fun doing it. So I am still a big paper crafter. I love to paper craft. That won't change, but right now home decor makes my heart happy. So hopefully you guys are here for it. Now, I found this frame at the Dollar General back in spring when it was 75% off, and I got it next to nothing. I found this cute little saying on Etsy and brought it into my design space on my Cricut, and I went ahead and put it on this. I painted the back piece and I put it on there with a little bit of greenery and of course some Buffalo Check. Now, this project was made for my sister. She recruited me to do a couple of projects for a silent auction for my niece's cheerleading squad. So this piece is supposed to be auctioned off. My sister's an hour and a half away, and I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get the projects to her in time. So fingers crossed that we can. If not, she got herself some free decor. So this says, "Chilling with my snowmies," turned out absolutely adorable. I went ahead and replaced the twine with the Buffalo Check ribbon, and this is just like a floating frame. It's so adorable. I absolutely adore it. Now, the next one, these guys turned out super duper cute. So last year I made a piece of wood to go under my Christmas tree to kind of fill up that dead space until Christmas came. And I found this word in design on Etsy. Yes, this one's on Etsy. I bought like a bundle pack with a bunch of Christmas sayings, and I cut it out on my Cricut, and I kind of just wanted to give it a 3D element. So I added some ribbon, and then I added this cute little ruffled bow here on the side for both. On this one, I added a cute little star, and then I just wanted it kind of to be not as colorful. So we do white, red, natural wood, and a little bit of gold. So we have the snowflake, a star, and then the pom-poms to it, you know, give it that 3D look. And then this one, I kind of added a little bit of red and green. And then look at that little fella that I put on my bow. So that's what they're meant for. Those guys are either like a shelf setter or even to put under the Christmas tree for that dead space until we get our delicious presents. So hopefully you guys like them. I need to know down below, is this something that you would purchase from me? I'm trying to get more familiar with my Cricut so that I can make pieces like that for sale. So these turned out super, I love the sayings, but I don't love how they turned out. I found these at Dollar General as well for 75% off. This one says, "Blessed Mama." This is also for the silent auction. This one says, "'Tis a season to sparkle." I figured winter season, it's got the sparkly stars in it. And then this guy says, "Resting mom face." So cute. I wish I would have used a different vinyl because it doesn't pop on the water bottles like I would like for it to. Now, these guys are pretty cool because they're meant to go in the freezer. And this kind of stuff, like the sparkles and stuff, freezes and then keeps your drink cold. So I thought those were nice. And then you guys, you got to check out Norm the Gnome. Okay. Now, bear with me. I have filmed this a couple of times because I couldn't get my words out. So if I have a hard time, you guys know me. It's not an Amanda video unless I mess up on my words. Norm the Gnome is so adorably cute. So here he is all together. And he does stand up on his own. He's actually really sturdy. I found Norm the Gnome's tutorial on Cozy Christmas Cottage. Now, her and her mama made one. Made two, actually. They each made one. And it was so darling. I had to make it. I just really wanted to give it a shot. And all of the products that I use on Norm the Gnome are from the Dollar Tree. Now, I took two Dollar Tree Christmas trees. So that's $2, $3, $4, $5 if you have to buy ornaments. So he's $5, you guys. Not bad, right? So I took two of the Christmas trees. And even with two of them and wrapping them together, I'm sorry, but it's still not that full. Not that full at all. But they used boots that they found during springtime at the Target. I knew I was not going to be able to find those boots, so I went on the hunt for what I could use for his boots. Now, he's got dust all over him because it is felt and it's picking everything up in my craft room. God forbid, but anyways, I found these boots. They were tencel boots. So gave me the shape of the boots, and I knew what I wanted to do. So I took poster board, and I took the tencel off, and I took poster board, and I outlined the boots with poster board to make them a little bit more sturdy. And then I took that the felt and just covered it with that. Now on the bottom of his boots, I'm losing rocks. On the bottom of his boots, the boots are just so dirty. They got lint all over them. On the bottom of his boots, you can see it's double layered. This is foam board. And I knew I had to make that sturdy because I need him to be able to stand up on his own. Now, Norm the Gnome has a bag of rocks in the bottom of his boots to keep him sturdy. So that turned out, that idea was really a great idea for boots. Now, his little beard. So I flocked his beard. I got them all together. I flocked his beard and I gave him a little bit more texture to him. And then for his little hat, I took a Dollar Tree scarf. They show you how to cut it. You want to cut it super long so it hangs to the side. And then you use that same scarf to make his mittens to match. So he turned out, I'm not in love. It's something, a piece that I definitely wouldn't sell. I would maybe give it away. And then you just use a little Dollar Tree ornament for his nose. Now, I wish I would have went with one of the gold ornaments to make it more flesh colored, or even maybe use a large bead. So if you guys want to make Norm the Gnome, that's his name. You can name yours whatever. I am going to link that video down below. If I forget, once again, I found it on the Cozy Christmas Cottage. I love her DIYs. They're truly easy and they honestly are affordable. So, you know, a lot of those girls are like, oh, Dollar Tree DIY. But if you buy all your products from Dollar Tree and as many items as you have to use, you could have either bought the product by the time you spend all that money, and or you could have went to like Hobby Lobby or the other places and found it so much cheaper. So I believe DIY Bethany, the Bethany girl, she tells you that up front, and I love that about her. So anyways, let me know down below, what do you think of my Norm the Gnome? And try to say that 3 times fast, you guys. I still have not heard from our winner yet. I'm hoping to hear from her very soon. And if not, we do have a deadline. So we'll just have Alexa, or is it? No, Siri. We'll have Siri pick us a new winner. All right, you guys. I actually did a update video. It was kind of like a car vlog. And I shared some controversial things in that vlog. If you guys would like to see more than just crafting from me, let me know down below. I will share that video if you would like to hear from me and a little bit about my journey and my life. But anyways, I know it's my channel, but I don't want to step outside of what you guys know if you're not interested. So if you enjoyed the last car vlog that I posted, it was a lot like that. Just let me know down below so that I can go ahead and upload that. And anyways, you guys, I'm so, so excited that we're continuing to grow, but that you guys are so amazing out there. You guys are, this community is over the moon amazing. Okay, I rambled enough. I'm finally going to let you go. I'll talk at you guys later. Bye-bye now.